Hello, I'm Mr. Arnold. Here is a lecture in Mythology, and I teach Christianity, Sikhism, and real Islam. Now, the holiest of holies used to be in Jerusalem, both the temple of Yahweh, where the Judah Iscariot threw it 30 shekels, because it had become blood money. And because Yahweh is the potter, this pot was created by Yahweh. So they took the money and bought a field called Potter's Field. So pot is created by Yahweh, Brahma, Khuda, same thing, in different languages. While the soul in us come from Elohim, Allah, Father. So here is the relationship between the two. Oh dear. Yeah. So this is menorah. These pots are created by Yahweh. And these, they are their works. The rabbi guide them to the works, and the works give you the next birth, karma. Works we call it karma. Karma gives you the next birth, reincarnation. Some are holy, some are evil. Social, ecumenical and political affair. That's all we do. Secular works. The middle candle is of Elohim, Allah Pabram, our supernatural father of our souls. The soul in us, you cannot see with these two naked eyes. You perceive it. And that belongs to our supernatural father. And that is in under Jewish system, they have the written Torah and the oral Torah. The oral Torah is His word. And this is the relationship between written and the oral Torah. Matthew 13 verse 52 define an ideal rabbi. He is the owner of a house, synagogue, who bringeth for treasure old scripture, this is scripture, you can read, written Torah, and the new is this one, oral Torah, ever fresh. It cannot be written down in ink on paper, because this is incorruptible, this is corruptible. Now the Jewish people, they were corrupting this scripture, especially Genesis 17 is full of corruption. Circumcision is the tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac only. Only the seed of Isaac can have circumcision, nobody else. I lived in Ghana. Over there people have tribal mark on their faces. So each tribe has its own mark. And nobody from other tribe can have that mark. Unless he is born in that tribe, you cannot have that tribal mark. So circumcision, unless you are born of the seed of Isaac, you cannot have circumcision. But in the temple, they were sitting in the front. The temple was divided. There was a wall sitting in the front and then on the back. It was divided because the rabbi or the priest, they get tithe, one-tenth. So those people who pay them one-tenth, they have the privilege to have that temple. It is made by them. So they were given the privilege to sit in front. So the people who come from outside, they were told to sit behind. And if somebody wanted to sit in front, those corrupt priests, no problem, give us money and get yourself circumcised. And then you become chosen people. And then you can sit in front. How can a Gentile, person of Aryan race or of Negro race, on circumcision, become the son of Isaac of the Semitic race? No way. This is the blindness they have, you know. The rabbis are so blind, you will be surprised. Sukkot means that thrown out of your family home because you are not faithful to father. And the rabbi tells them that it is a holiday. The Jacob had 12 sons. Joseph was truthful, sort of Abraham and Yahweh. So they were eating meagerly on behalf of that Joseph. As soon as they sold him as a slave, there were none who was faithful to Brahma, to Yahweh. That means they were saltless people. Abraham is the father of the faithful, not of the unfaithful. So Yahweh who bring Abram from the Iraq area to settle in the Middle East as Adam, Sarah as Eve, and he gave them the promised land at the Garden of Eden. He wasn't happy, so he stopped rain, and the land became barren, and they had to leave the promised land. When they left the promised land, it is the same thing. They are enjoying Sukkot. They leave their family home, and they make in the garden a tabernacle, or a hut, you know, to stay overnight there, because father has thrown them out, being unfaithful to father. And they do the practice of this, all these things, but still they don't learn lesson from it, because the rabbi, instead of repenting that I am unfaithful to Abraham, and asking for forgiveness, they say, you enjoy it. It is a festival. So such type of rabbi, what can you learn from them? That's why Jesus called them blind guide of the blind. They were making people Jew outwardly. Jew is one who is of heart, spiritual, not the physical. So here it is. Under Adam you have races, under races you have tribes. So here you are, outwardly, tribal people. The tribal people, they are the rightful owner of this planet Earth. So that's why 144,000 they are mentioned all by their tribes and not as Jews. So under God, way of life, we have this saint who come to deliver his word. Here we have prophet. Here we have saint. Saints are the very son of Elohim, Allah Pabram, our supernatural father of our souls. So Hindu, Sikh, Jew, etc., you know, they are spiritual self. Yourself to improve your way of life. They are never born, they never die. So not a single Jew, Hindu, Sikh or Muslim or a Christian died ever in the sectarian riots. But the tribal people, misled by their dog collar priest or by their mullahs or other religious leaders like Gandhi, Lala Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi, and then Lala Tara Singh Malhotra Khatri, then Lala Muhammad Ali Jinnah Babla Patia. These three shopkeepers, they divided our country on the religious basis and created this bloodshed. So they are responsible for those bloodshed. And this is common in this dark age, because people, very rare, they understand religion. Most of them go by what the rabbi tells them or what the mullah tells them, without questioning. And they end up in sectarian riots. In India, Punjab, where I come from, I'm from Jat tribe. My tribal people are in Pakistan, my tribal people are in India. So whenever there's a fight between India and Pakistan, we kill each other. And that's what happened in, under the these mullahs and religious teachers, you know. They brainwash the people. So Christianity of heart is one in a million. And so it's not that cheap. The Christians of the book, they are here. John the Baptist, they are here. Law and prophets were till John the Baptist, Luke 16, verse 16. After that one, when you are reached the age of 20 or above, then you have studied the scripture. Then you start seeking the root of the scripture, which is Oral Torah. And if your rabbi have this knowledge, then he will give you introduction. As the Samaritan rabbi had this knowledge of the Oral Torah. So they give instruction to their grown-up disciples. As Samaritan woman at the well, she was well versed in the spirituality that was given by her rabbi. There were no divisions among them. Among the spiritually blind rabbis of the chosen people, they are Pharisees, Sadducees, this and that. But no division among the Samaritan rabbis. Because although they were solitary, they were of one accord. So it's a pity, you know, people do not understand this one so much so. Yesterday I went to attend this Palestinian demonstration in Reading. They were against the Barclays Bank, because Barclays Bank had donated money to Israel. And so I talked to a Palestinian person and told him that the Nanak in India was the second coming of Jesus. He was surprised. He said, ah, the Jewish people, they said their Messiah will come after the war. So to them, Christ Jesus is not the Messiah. Even they are trying to raise his name altogether, telling people different stories that he was never born, is a mystic. Is it just evil monger or something, you know. So Christ is known to people who have discerning intellect, not to people who have no common sense at all. Church of England, when their soldier died, their priest said they glorify God. So their God is Mammon and not Mammon free. Elohim Allah Pabram. So there is nothing wrong for the Jewish people to put the partition in the temple of Yahweh, because they paid the tithe to the priest. So the priest has to attend them first, then the other people. So our Father God blesses you. There are many more things you can learn, and it's all in your heart. Once you are twice born here, when you enter the royal kingdom of God, here your soul is concerned, not your physical body. Here your physical body is concerned, not soul. What applies to flesh? The opposite applies to spirit. In flesh, the rabbi, they boost your ego. They boost your ego so much so that if somebody hit you, then hit him back well. Take all his teeth out. On the other hand, here Christ Jesus said, if somebody hit you, present the other teeth. By presenting the other cheek, we hit at the conscience of the person, not the physical body. We ask him, why did you hit me? What wrong I have done, so I may not do next time. So if he is a man of conscience, then he will be sorry. If he is not conscience, saltless person, then he will say, I will hit you more. Those people in the Jewish people, in the temple, they were making them Jew outwardly and could not build their covenant with Abraham. So they were unfaithful to Abraham, unfaithful to Yahweh, saltless people. That's why Jesus went told in the temple that he is the Messiah. Then they took stones to kill him, that now you say you are God, because they know Son represents the Father. Now you say you are God, now we must kill you. They were saltless people. The people born of water, faithful to Abraham, faithful to Yahweh, the Samaritans at the well, when Jesus told her that he is the Messiah, and there were no doubt in her mind, she was so happy. She went to her village and told everyone that I have found him. And you have to test him yourself, because Messiah is known to Messiah. Christ is known to Christ and not to the Christian. So here the people are Christ. Here people are Christ. St. Thomas went to India. Over there he was known as Christ Thomas. And so were his laborers. He had preached them gospel from the core of his heart. And not any book, you know, not scripture. They had the full knowledge of scripture in India. And they were born of water because they were a tribal identity in their name. So they did not need baptism. So St. Thomas went there and preached them the gospel. And they were known as Christ, not Christian. Portuguese Pope went there. He said, no, you can't call yourself Christ. Only one Christ Jesus. And he killed them, he burned their books and all that, you know. He made a havoc as the Antichrist was making all over the world. So they left their prosperous businesses, and went and hide in hills and from the Pope. That is how the Pope Antichrist killed the Christianity in India. The local rabbis, they were not inefficient. So they, because what applied to flesh, the opposite to spirit. So the local rabbis told St. Thomas, you are misguiding our people. and they killed him. They were efficient, they were not inefficient. Not like the Jewish people in the Israel. They were much more qualified. They were not spiritually blind. So with many things I can tell, but no customer yet. Customer will come because atomic war is not far away. So let's join hands together and preach gospel from the rooftop and earn our rest as Lazarus earned his rest. So on the death of Lazarus, he ended up in the lap of Abraham, the rich man in the fire. Now these rabbis, these messianic Jews, you know, they are the one who wrote the Bible and everything. So they put that when Jesus died, he went to hell and then he went to heaven. All that nonsense. If Lazarus did not go to hell, he was straight in the lap of Abraham, a saint, then how can Jesus go to hell first and then to in the lap of Abraham or in the royal kingdom of God? So think again, it's all here in your own heart. Don't go by what is written in the book. What is written is corruptible. What you get through logical reasoning is incorruptible. And that is called logo, and logo is his word, and his word is the face of God, oral Torah, which the Jewish people hated because it will bring their corruption to light. So let's join hands together and preach gospel from the rooftop. My services are free. So anybody want to talk with me, he can contact me and we can have a chat on Messenger or on Skype or anything like that. Our Father God blesses everyone in agape, unconditional divine love.